Hello, everybody. This is Daniel Babis. Welcome back to Daily Soap Dish. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button down below. We cover a ton of 90 Day Fiancé. All right, so let's get into it. Today, we're going to be talking about a bunch of different topics. We're going to be talking about Jorge Nava and Anfissa Arkhipchenko. We're also going to be talking about Kenneth and Armando on this season of The Other Way. And we're also going to be talking a little bit about Nicole Naftiger and an update on her situation. So let's get into it. We're going to start with Jorge Nava and Anfissa Arkhipchenko and the situation, where it's at and what's going on. So basically, news broke today that Jorge Nava has filed for divorce from Anfissa Arkhipchenko. It actually happened earlier this week, but the news has just broken that the two are, well, they haven't been a pair for a while, but Jorge Nava has officially applied for divorce. So basically, what happened is that he cited irreconcilable differences in the as the reason for the divorce. But we know that this couple hasn't been a thing for a few years because, of course, Jorge Nava was serving a 2.5 jail sentence for selling drugs, and when he was released, well, the relationship was no longer a thing. So basically what happened is that in 2018, Jorge Nava was arrested for possessing over 300 pounds of marijuana. That's a pretty hefty amount of drugs. And he was not only possessing it, but he was trying to sell it. And so he got arrested and he got put in jail as a result. Now, during the time of his jail sentence, it appears that Anfissa kind of like was not interested in being with Jorge Nava anymore. So she kind of started seeking another man. And basically, that's when the relationship broke down. So the relationship hasn't been a thing for a while now. So this comes as no surprise to anybody. But basically, if you thought that there was a slim, you know, chance that these two could get together, well, here you have it. It's not going to happen. They are officially done and going their other ways. Well, in fact, actually, they have already gone their other ways. Jorge Nava already has another girlfriend. And Anfissa, actually, like I said, she was supposed to be dating someone even while Jorge was in jail, which I guess it's almost like she was kind of cheating on him since their divorce wasn't officialized, but whatever, that is their business. She is dating this other guy named Leo. Both couples appear to be pretty happy with their respective new spouses. And so there we have it. But like I said, he cited irreconcilable differences, and he claims that Anfissa abandoned her husband during his jail sentence. On another topic of this couple, I have to say that Jorge, when he was released from prison, he kind of released this clothing line. So his clothing line is called Kilos to Paris. So of course, Kilos kind of hinting at some kind of drug substance. Kilos to Paris, he's kind of hinting at smuggling drugs to Paris. At least that's how I took it. At least that's how many people seem to take it. And that seems to be his business endeavor. So it leads me to question whether or not Jorge Nava has learned his lesson from serving jail time for selling 300 pounds of marijuana just a few years ago. But nonetheless, that is his problem. And if ever he goes back to doing what he was doing before, which is possessing and selling massive amounts of drugs, well, he will go back into jail, and it will probably be for a longer period of time. So this is where we're at with this couple. Now look, both of these people have gone their separate ways. We don't know what is going on with them. Could Jorge Nava come back on the show with his new girlfriend? It is a possibility in the future. Could Anfissa and her boyfriend Leo come back on the show? It's a possibility in the future. We will just have to wait and see what happens. All right, let's talk a little bit about Nicole Naftiger, and that's because she has been all over the news lately, and that's because she's still stuck in Morocco. So basically what happened with Nicole is that she went to Morocco in early March, right before the corona pandemic hit in a big way. So she went there just before everything shut down. So as a result of that, she has been stuck in Morocco for, it seems like, over 5 months now. And look, a lot of people are criticizing this girl. They are calling her a bad, horrible parent. They're saying that she has abandoned May, and she, you know, she is just a bad, bad person, and she is more interested in spending time with Azan than being with her daughter, May. Now, the thing is, guys, is this is not the whole story. A lot of people have been critical of Nicole for multiple reasons. It seems like this girl is getting it from all sides, from everywhere, basically, because some people actually don't even believe that she's in Morocco. Some people think that she has used this whole Morocco story for publicity, like it's a massive publicity stunt, like she has just been promoting it just to kind of stay relevant on social media, to create a story about her, to create buzz about her, to say like, woe is me, oh, I am so, you know, I'm stuck here, please have some sympathy for me, or something like that. Look, I don't know, guys. The people that are saying that, they're saying that Nicole, who is usually active on Instagram, she hasn't been posting a lot of recent pictures with her and Azan in Morocco. Well, Nicole took to Instagram in the last few days and she has posted a few lives about her life in Morocco. I believe in one she was in Agadir and she was showing the village in Agadir, and then a bunch of others, kind of like, I believe she was showing that as proof to say, guys, look, this is not a lie. I am really in Morocco and I am really stuck here. So the latest news for the Nicole Navzegger story is that on August 10, I believe, is when she will be able to take a plane and depart. Morocco World News reported that non-resident foreigners within Morocco's borders will be expected to depart the country by August 10. So it seems like Nicole should be able within the next few days to take a flight and go back home to see her daughter May. Now, look, a lot, like I said, a lot of people have been criticizing Nicole, but Nicole and her mother, they have tried to dispel these rumors that Nicole has just abandoned May and that she is a horrible parent. Her mother came and, you know, I believe she did a post just a few weeks ago, and she said that Nicole actually, she FaceTimes with her daughter each and every day. They watch TV together on FaceTime. Nicole even watches as her daughter May plants peppers in the garden and all kind of things. Also, her mother has said that, yeah, you guys might think that this is really bad, but in fact, this is a great thing because for me as a grandparent, well, I get to spend a lot of time with my granddaughter, and this is a special time, and we are getting to bond and spend a lot of quality time that otherwise we wouldn't have. And, you know, I gotta say, guys, if the story is true, and look, some people believe that Nicole is lying, some people believe that she is telling the truth, but if the story is true, guys, generally grandparents, they love to dote on their grandchildren, so I have to say that Nicole should be well taken care of if the story is true. So that is just my opinion. A lot of people have very different opinions on this matter of Nicole Navzegger. So look, you guys tell me what you think about this whole thing in the comment section down below. But it looks like Nicole should be able to go back to the US very, very shortly. All right, now I just want to talk a little bit about Kenneth and Armando, because I think this couple is like a ray of sunshine on this season of The Other Way. I think they're a fan favorite, and I can't think of one person that really dislikes this couple, and that's because they seem to have a true love story going on. And, you know, we had Stephanie and Erica last season on 90 Day Fiancé, but most people, myself included, and I have said this before, and I will continue saying it, most people believe that that was a phony relationship. It was only done for social media gain. On Stephanie's side, it was only done so she could grow her YouTube channel that was already pretty big before she came on the show. So a lot of people believe that that relationship was a publicity stunt. And of course, we have learned in the past weeks that Erica actually now has a boyfriend, so which gives rise to more questions about the whole thing. But regardless of that, I want to focus on Kenny and Armando, in my opinion, the first true, genuine, same-sex relationship on 90 Day Fiancé. I think this couple is great, and look, I hope to see much more of them in the future. But basically, what's going on right now is that after we kind of like, you know, after the introduction, and of course we saw Armando, you know, kind of like in this conservative Mexican society, he has tried to come out of the closet in the past, and it kind of failed because, you know, like his family family weren't very welcoming. They weren't very accepting. And so he has kind of had to shut the door on that closet for a few years. But just recently on the show, he has reopened that door and he has come out of the closet. And he has said, now is my time. I am going to come out no matter what, because this is who I truly am. And you know, if you guys accept me, you know, I would love for that to happen. And if you guys don't accept me, well, you're just going to have to deal with it, because this is who I truly am. And I really respect that about Armando. I know it's very difficult. You can really see and feel how hard it is, you know, the weight of this conservative society, of this conservative family of his. You could really feel it in Armando, so you could just tell how difficult it really is for him to kind of come out and break the mold, in a sense. But basically what is happening now is, of course, we saw Kenny kind of make that journey to Mexico. It took a few days from Florida. He had to leave behind his four children that were, you know, they were very, very sad, and were almost kind of guilting Kenny into leaving. I mean, you know, they kind of wanted to stay. Of course, his daughters, I believe, they have some children. And Kenny seems like the perfect grandparent. He's always taking care of his grandchildren. So I bet that his children are feeling the pain of having to take care more of their children more. But regardless of that, so Kenny made the journey to Mexico. And, you know, his first few days were a little rough in Mexico, right? He had a bit of a culture shock, which, by the way, to me, I didn't really quite understand, since, of course, Kenny came to Mexico in the past, a year before this, the season of The Other Way was filmed, and he was spending some quality time with Armando, and I believe his family was there as well. They went wine tasting, and they did a whole bunch of things. And it seemed like Kenny was perfectly fine with Mexican culture, but of course, just, you know, going somewhere to vacation and going somewhere to live are two completely different things. Now, when you move somewhere to live, the whole society, it hits you in a very, very different way, because your responsibilities are just different. Now you have to adapt to that culture. You have to adapt to that society. You have to make your mark in that society. So there is a lot more pressure that goes into moving somewhere than, of course, just spending time, you know, vacationing somewhere, which you are not connected whatsoever with that country. You're just there to have a good time. So I can totally understand, in a way, you know, Kenny moving to Mexico and trying to find employment there, and how hard that could be. One of the things that I just don't understand is Kenny said he doesn't like horchata. And when he said that, I just lost it. I'm like, who doesn't like horchata? If anybody has ever had horchata, it is milky, it is sweet, and I believe in Aztec culture, it's called the drink of the gods. Everybody loves horchata. I make it every year at Christmas parties, and I'm not even Mexican. Everybody loves it. I did not understand when Kenny said he didn't like horchata. Let's move on to the point. The point is that this week we're gonna see Kenny propose to Armando. So this whole love story is going to come full circle, and Kenny is going to propose to Armando. So finally, we're going to have some happiness, some real happiness. And the real question is first of all, is Armando going to say yes? Yeah, he's most likely going to say yes. I mean, of course, you know, if you watch the preview for this upcoming episode, you know, they will kind of leave you hanging. But let's be honest here, Armando is going to say yes. So I just wanted to update you guys on that, because this is, like I said, this is one of my favorite stories on the season of The Other Way. It's actually one of my favorite stories of any season of 90 Day Fiancé, because I find both of these characters just incredibly lovable, incredibly charming, and very interesting in their own ways. They come across like real people, just very genuine, and I just really love to see that, and I hope to see more of it. Of course, if Armando says yes, you know, they will be engaged, but of course the marriage is going to happen at some other point in the future. I don't believe that point is going to be filmed on the season of The Other Way. We will have to wait and see. So it's very likely that we might see Kenny and Armando on a future season of 90 Day Fiancé, where perhaps they will marry. Who knows? Because the timeline on the show, sometimes it advances very, very quickly. You could have one episode that, you know, takes place right now, and another episode that takes place in a couple of weeks or even months. So it remains to be seen, but I have a sneaky suspicion that we will see this couple again in the future. Alright guys, so that does it for this video. Don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up if you enjoy the content. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below for more 90 Day Fiancé. And guys, I just wanted to show you one thing before I let you go. I just wanted to show you this view right here, because this is just magnificent. And I know that some of you guys have commented on my pictures and whatnot, but this is the actual special thing about where I am sitting. You can just see here, the sunset is just beautiful right here.